in beautiful Miami with singer-songwriter Patti Austin, and we're lucky enough to have her sing the song from the movie Shirley Valentine, the Oscar-nominated The Girl Who Used to Be Me. Ladies and gentlemen, Patti Austin.
Born to fly, born for the moment it takes to the sky and all its dreams are riding on its wings. But if it falls, our dreams aren't broken as long as the
to watch the Oscars, doesn't it? So you'll get to see Patti there.
Yeah. what?
We're both in that song, and Shirley Valentine,
yeah,
the whole thing.
Kind of a woman's song.
It is. It
yeah.
is a woman's song.
Yeah.
Now, you've done so many jingles, and we hate, I mean, you get millions of dollars to sing all these things, and we want you to sing a couple for us. Can you just do a few of your jingles, your favorite ones?
It's wonderful. Marvelous. For Crest.
And that's for Crest.
Yeah. Apple cinnamon Cheerios.
Is that you?
I do those things. Well, hey, it's a little bit of
knowledge.
Soup with collagen says welcome with a smile.
You know that commercial?
You know,
I mean,
that
this
one.
Is Patti Austin.
Soup,
makes
guys.
Records.
Soup.
Now, tell us about your love life.
Yeah, we talked about this. Now, are you married?
It's so early in the
day. I know. Try and shore up.
Am I
married? Are you married?
No, I'm definitely not married.
Been
Which
married
could be why
ever?
I'm still smiling.
Yeah.
No, never been married.
Never. Want to be married?
Ooh, some radicals
yeah,
over there.
Yeah, there are a lot of radicals in this audience. Ignore them. Pay no attention
okay.
to them.
Right. Now, do you want to be married? Is that something in your life you want?
See, I'm very into commitment and responsibility. And I think that a lot of people fall in love and get married and don't realize that they have to work.
Yeah.
And I take up all my energy working on this, so I can't really fairly involve somebody else in my life at this point and give them what they're going to need and what I know I'm going to need.
Yeah.
So right now, no. Maybe in a year.
Really?
Yeah. Maybe in a
Why
year.
Why in a year?
Well, because I've been working at my career literally since I was four, but
yeah.
really since I was about 17 years old. Because before that is like being a little pregnant, which is impossible. You know, I could only
yeah.
do but so much work because I was going to school.
Yeah.
But, and it's been kind of a steady, wonderful climb with a really good, strong foundation. But now my career is really kind of coming into focus. I can kind of say, okay, I know I'm going to have this time off, and I can
yeah.
say, yes, I'll work now. And no, So I'm in a position
you,
where I can
you feel like
control my life a little
you're
more.
You're arrived now. Do you feel
what?
Like you've made it on some level?
Well, I feel I've made it as a human being, not
right.
necessarily in show business, whatever that is. You know,
yeah.
I always say I love the show and hate the business. So,
I know.
You
relate to that.
Yeah.
Yes.
But,
oh, yeah.
But, I mean, I think I'm fairly well evolved for a 40-year-old broad.
And you are, she's so down to earth, so real. And that's really, doesn't that come through in her music?
In her music.
It just better.
Yeah.
Patti Austin speaks. Patti Austin, everybody.
Yeah.
Yes.
Watch her on the Oscars.
Next, new weapons in the war against wrinkles. So stay tuned.
Yeah, we'll
Patti
be right.
Austin.
Wrinkles.
Great. Oh,
wrinkles.
Want to
hang around? Want to be the next?
Well,
let's face it. If you have wrinkles and you want to get rid of them, if you don't have them yet, you're worried that you're going to get them, and how do you avoid that, right? All of that nonsense. There are hundreds, literally hundreds of products that promise younger skin, removes wrinkles, rejuvenates the skin. Do they really help get rid of them? We're going to find out, okay? Here to tell us a new wrinkle on an old subject.
Little joke.
Yeah,
it was good. I like that.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Is the author of, and I have to show you, Blue Eyeshadow Should Be Illegal. That was her first book, and this is still illegal. Paula Begon. I love the title. Hi, Paula.
Hi. It's a good title. No, I don't have blue eyeshadow on.
No, God, no.
No.
Your mother-in-law still
yes,
wears
my
it.
My mother-in-law still, yeah. God bless her,
yeah.
wears
yeah.
blue
yeah.
eyeshadow.
Yeah.
What can I do?
Tell me, what causes wrinkles? Why? That the sun? The only reason?
95%. I think it'd be hard put nowadays, especially after Retin-A, to find any dermatologist, any plastic surgeon, who would tell you that the sun is not the major contributor, if not the only contributor, to affect wrinkles on the skin. Dr. Albert Kligman, who invented, holds the patent
right.
on Retin-A, is doing a study, taking a look at monks in Japan.
Yes.
Who, you know, stay inside and don't go out for ever and ever, and they're like 80 years old, and you look at their skin under a microscope, and in comparison to a child's skin, you can't tell the difference.
Is that right?
Right. So what the, and there's lots of studies going on like that now, and so sure, pretty much.
So it's not even sun, like lying down in it.
It's
it has to
like,
do with
just
sun
like,
walking
right,
around.
By about the age of 40, from just living, if you're particularly light-skinned, you run a bigger risk. If you're darker skin, if you're black and, you know, sallow. And
it affects
that,
all of us.
Right, but it affects less the darker the skin because you got your own built-in sunblock.
Oh,
The black skin has built-in natural melanin that protects the skin from the sun. That's why we get tan. That brown color is to protect our skin from the sun. Right. And so that's why you start producing all that stuff to keep those rays off. But
now,
that's what ages the skin.
I thought until I read your book that if you had dry skin, you were more prone to wrinkles.
That
and
cosmetic
if you were oily,
company would love for you to believe that.
That's not true.
No, it's not true. Not only isn't it true, but think about it for a second. If dry skin and wrinkles were associated, then 10-year-old kids with dry skin would wrinkle. And guess what? They don't. They wait till they grow up just like we do.
Yeah.
So all the moisturizers, all the oils, all the funny little products, all the $50 creams, give it to somebody you like, or you know, the money, not the product. In fact, give the product to somebody you don't like because they'll think
it
you're doing
nothing.
Something. It means nothing. Now, that doesn't mean that dry skin. No, but that doesn't mean moisturizers don't. I'm not going to like end buying moisturizers. Moisturizers serve a purpose because dry skin is uncomfortable. Dry skin looks more wrinkled. You know, like a leaf, like a leaf on the ground.
And then